President Marcos approves a five-year national cybersecurity plan amid attempts by China-based hackers to infiltrate government websites. The Philippine ICT Department says the plan provides policy direction and operational guidelines on how the country can fortify its cybersecurity systems.
We presented the national cybersecurity plan to the president. This was more than a year in the making. And it actually is a very comprehensive plan covering the year 2024 to 2028.
The DICT, meanwhile, says it has yet to determine the motive behind the cyber attack after tracing it to China Unicom, a Chinese state-owned telecommunications company. It adds Beijing has offered to help probe the cyber attacks. President Marcos slams calls for a separate Mindanao, saying the plan is doomed to fail. During a speech Thursday, Marcos did not mention former President Rodrigo Duterte and Davao del Norte lawmaker Pantaleon Alvarez, who floated the proposal, but urged those behind the effort to stop what he called a constitutional travesty.
I strongly appeal to all concerned to stop this call for a separate Mindanao. It is a grave violation of the Constitution. Hindi ito ang bagong Pilipinas na ating hinuhubog. Bagkus, ito ay pagwasak mismo sa ating bansang Pilipinas.
In another event, Marcos also called for the unity for the whole country.
That as brothers and sisters united under one nation, we can forge a better future in a kinder society where opportunities reward hard work. Dreams can come true, and peace with justice will reign. A stronger Barm means a stronger Mindanao. A stronger Mindanao. A stronger Mindanao means a stronger Philippines, bringing us closer to achieving our agendas.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. making his stand clear on charter change. In a speech during Thursday's celebration of the Philippine Constitution Day, Marcos said he welcomes some reforms to the 1987 Constitution. But he clarifies his administration's push for charter change is only limited to economic provisions.
Many sectors of society, particularly business, have pointed to certain economic provisions in the Constitution that inhibit our growth momentum. That is why, since the 8th Congress, there have been no less than 300 measures filed in the House of Representatives calling for the amendment of these economic provisions of our Constitution. And we must allow this healthy and democratic debate to rage on. I want to make it clear. This administration's position in introducing reforms to our Constitution extend to economic matters alone, or those strategically aimed at boosting our country's economy. Nothing more.
Efforts to amend the charter have been hounded by controversies amid fears it would be used for political agendas, including extending the terms of politicians. The bickering continues between the two chambers of Congress over charter change. A Philippine senator now accusing House lawmakers of bullying. Sherian Torres has more.
PBA Party List lawmaker Margarita Nograles denies any involvement in the signature campaign behind the controversial People's Initiative for Charter Change. Nograles was linked by several witnesses during the hearing of the Senate Committee on Electoral Reforms and People's Participation in Davao City last Friday, which is investigating bribery allegations involving the initiative. One witness, Richelle Sequeira, identified herself as a village coordinator of the PBA Partylist group, which promotes the interests of athletes and the youth. She said she gave out claim stubs to those who signed the signature form for the People's Initiative. Nograles calls the accusations baseless.
Paano ako makakapagbigay ng pera? Paano ako makakapag-mobilize ng mga tao? I was out of the country. If totoo nga ang sinasabi nila na ako nga ay nagbigay daw ng pera, paano ko nagawa yun? Parang magic lang?
The lawmaker also issues a challenge against her accusers.
Meron at meron. pwedeng gumawa nung kung ano-ano pa para ipagmukha kang masama. Pero kung totoong may ginawang masama, then file the case with the proper courts.
Meanwhile, the word war between both houses of Congress shows no sign of tapering off, with House Leader Representative Elizalde Co questioning the integrity of Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, who earlier dismissed the challenge of his House counterpart Manuel Jose Dalipe for senators to make public their stand on charter change. Co warns Villanueva not to belittle House members as he reminds the senator of his track record as a public official when he was linked to the multi-billion peso pork barrel scam. Co says he was disappointed with the statements of Villanueva, who was once a member of the chamber as a party list representative. In response, Villanueva released to the media a screenshot of the Office of the Ombudsman's 2019 ruling that dismissed his PDAF case and the line, "Liars go to hell." Meanwhile, Senator Sani Angara, who is leading the public hearing for resolution of both houses number 6, accuses congressmen of ganging up on senators.
Biro mo araw-araw, di ba parang bully yun? Pumunta ka ng CR, tapos andun na naman yung bully. Parang, guys, mag-break naman. Parang time out. Magtrabaho naman tayo.
Angara maintains they need to determine if there is really a need to amend the charter. He also rejects pressure from congressmen to approve the resolution before the session break in March. Senator Cheese Escudero is also hitting back at their House counterparts, challenging them to come clean on what he describes as a fake people's initiative. For the president's sister, Senator Amy Marcos again calls for a stop to the People's Initiative, saying proponents are misrepresenting the signature campaign.
Sana i-atras na muna yung PI nila. Gawin natin sa tamang pamamaraan. Nakaka-insulto naman yung ginagawa na halos hindi maintindihan ng tao yung pinipirmahan nila. Nakatakip pa yung provision.
Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.
More bodies retrieved from the deadly landslide in Davao de Oro. The death toll now at 11. Over 100 more remain missing. Bad weather has been hampering rescue efforts, but search teams are hopeful they will find more survivors. Local authorities also investigating safety in the area, which has been repeatedly hit by landslides in the past years.
Which also prompted the province to really create interventions. There is the so-called no habitation policy. So ito yung mga bagay-bagay na kailangan din namin i-review ulit.
Meanwhile, residents from other landslide-prone villages were forced to flee their homes. Heavy rains have been battering parts of Mindanao for weeks, killing dozens of people. Shoppers flock to Chinatown in Binondo to ring in the Chinese New Year with food and decorations. Take a look.
Amelia Alfonso traveled from Pasay City to Binondo in Manila just to buy boxes of tikoy for her relatives and friends. Amelia says each year she spends about 2,000 pesos just for this item, a tradition they have kept in their family for decades.
Nakagays na ako sa magulang ko kahit Pinoy tayo. Na pag may ganyan, namimigay sila ng maliliit na tikoy. Minsan, pag nakalimutan ko ganito, ayoko nang masikip dahil may mga madaling araw, alas dos, punta ako, mamimili lang ako ng tikoy.
Jomar Angpoyas, who works in one of the oldest dumpling shops in the capital's Chinatown, says they have been working overtime recently as the number of orders in the run-up to the Chinese New Year tripled compared to what they get on regular days.
Talagang mabenta po pag Chinese New Year kasi yung dumplings po, yan yung pinapaniwalaan nila na maswerte sa ating kakainin.
Some shops that sell lucky charms, trinkets, and decorations are open 24 hours a day to cater to the deluge of customers seeking to find the perfect amulet and other auspicious items in welcoming the new year. Some charms to attract wealth are sold for as low as 50 pesos, while other items fetch as much as 5,000 pesos depending on its size and design. Sammy Lim, Chairman Emeritus of the Philippine Retailers Association, says agriculture and food industries usually profit the most during this season, as most of this holiday's traditions involve consuming food with auspicious meanings.
The first dish they would eat is basically a dumpling. A dumpling, just like a gyoza, is shaped like a gold ingot. That's why, you know, it's very lucky. And the second thing they would definitely eat is noodles. It's all about long life.
Lim says those in the poultry business also see improved sales during Chinese New Year, as chicken feet and wings are among the dishes usually served for good fortune every Chinese New Year.
Claw is supposed for you to get a better grasp of the money. And then there's the wing that is supposed to make you fly higher in your career, in your, you know, search for wealth and all that.
Tikoy is a popular choice of gift in welcoming the new year, as it symbolizes the stickiness of ties among families and friends. Wilson Flores, an official from the Federation of Filipino Chinese Chambers of Commerce and Industry, adds the tradition of handing out ang pao, or money placed in red envelopes, also helps the economy.
Nakakatulong yun sa spending, kasi yung mga Chinese families, hindi lang Pilipinas, all over Asia. Ang paniwala kasi, pag ikaw namimigay ka, good luck din yun for you.
Flores adds, there are also some benefits to the tourism industry, as Chinese New Year is usually a week-long holiday in some countries. He says the increased spending is expected to last for a few more days after the world officially marks the start of the auspicious year of the dragon. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.